Hey everyone, Gabriel MC for Channel Firewall and Ultimate Guard, and today I'm back with some Modern. I'm back with Temeshi Bloom combo, and I'm going to be playing the list that came in third in one of the latest Modern Challenge. I think it was even the Modern Showcase, a little more prestigious, and yeah, kind of a different angle. There's not a ton of different cards compared to the list I was playing, but slightly more of a glass cannon angle, no Renin 6, no Tracker, no second Omnath. I was also playing Mishra's Bubble, a Crater Footfall as kind of a win condition instead of Finale of Devastation. But yeah, let's get into the list. Let's start by describing the deck for those who haven't seen it in action before. It's a combo deck that tries to use Lotus Bloom with Temeshi. And what happens is that basically for one white, you get to return Lotus Bloom and return a land to your hand. So for every land you have in play, you can generate two mana. So typically what you're hoping to do is to suspend Lotus Bloom on turn one. On turn four, your Lotus Bloom comes into play. You have four lands. You play Temeshi. Play Temeshi, get the Lotus Bloom. You have four extra mana. Then for each land you have in play, you generate two extra mana. So you have four lands, meaning you generate another eight mana. And that gives you 10 mana to either cast Colossus if you have it in your hand, Wargate for Colossus, Call for Colossus and cast it. And the Colossus lets you put back all the lands back into play. They're tabbed, but as long as you have one white floating, you can go again with Lotus Bloom. And usually, once you've cast the first Colossus, it's game over. You basically never fizzle. And once you've done that, you generate more mana, keep going off, and eventually kill them with Finale of Devastation. I had a version where I decided Finale of Devastation was not the greatest card to have in your opening hand, so I was playing a Crater Footfall, which is a Cyclone enchantment that's an aura you enchanted to a land. You tap the land to give haste to a creature. So what you would do is cycle it, and when you're going off at some point, you bring it back with Temeshi, and you give your Colossus haste. You can even do it twice and give two different Colossus haste. But yeah, as I said, this version more glass cannony, grazer, basically explore over Renin 6, so more explosiveness, but maybe less consistency. And also a cool addition, Turn Timber Symbiosis, just a little extra value, extra lands with Grazer too. You see 23 lands, but really it's 26 with Turn Timber, which is kind of the minimum you need to have, honestly, if you're going to play Grazer and Explore. And as far as Glass Cannony goes, the sideboard, I feel, is also in that, playing in that angle, I guess, was Defense Grid to protect your combo and some kind of haymakers. Leyline of Sanctity, I kind of like, can actually cast it, and why not? Leyline of the Void, I don't know. Leylines in these decks, kind of sketchy. I'm not a big fan of Leylines when you don't have ways to recycle them. I mean, sure, you can cast them in these decks, but ideally you want Leylines in a deck where you can A, recycle them if you draw them after your opening hand, and B, cast them and maybe have them be relevant down the line. And Cosmic Sands, who's a player who played to a third place finish, decided to still keep the free hate bears. As Deputy's pretty cool. I wasn't playing Deputy. I was thinking maybe it's for Rhino tokens. We'll see. They also decided to go with Skyclave Apparition, which is also kind of that glass cannon angle, like protecting your combo, not trying to gain value, really just getting rid of a needle, getting rid of a Teferi. I was kind of disappointed the one league I think I played with Skyclave. I'm kind of skeptical of a lot of the card choices. I'm a little skeptical on two Odawara, two Baseju, no basic island, only the basic forest, basic plains. I'm kind of skeptical about two Finale of Devastation. And I'm pretty skeptical of all these ley lines in the sideboard. But I figured it'd be cool to try the deck, but with a slightly different list. And once again, that's like kind of that glass cannon angle I was talking, or not glass cannon, but maybe just really about protecting the combo. You don't really have a great plan B, and yeah, I'm interested to see what happens. So that's the deck. I talked about the combo to round out the deck. You've got Call, really good, just tutors, your combo pieces, the one engineer that can get you Lotus Bloom, and Wargate just... that's why this deck is so strong, because all your... You don't really have any dead cards. All your combo pieces kind of replace themselves. You don't really have that... still stuck at zero trophy, really. I guess I haven't played much Modern lately. You don't have these combo pieces that do nothing. Typically in a combo deck, like, I don't know, if you go old school a bit, Illusions Donate, you know, you've got Donate that's literally a card that does nothing until you win. Illusions at least can gain you some life and maybe buy you a draw step or two to top deck the Donate, but typically in the history of Magic, when you've had combo decks, the combo decks have had pieces that do nothing kind of on themselves, and this deck, that's not the case. You know, Wargate can get you a land, Lotus Bloom, Call can get you an Omnath, and kind of all clicks pretty well together. All right, the Enduring Idealist. It's a card I haven't seen in a while. Colony Garden could be the Glimpse deck, could be combo versus combo. If they're playing Glimpse, though, they might be in a world of hurt against my turn two Teferi. If that's what they're up to. Who else plays Colony Garden in Modern besides Glimpse of Tomorrow? And how do they deal with Teferi? I guess they have Fury to deal with Teferi. Yeah. So I have a decision. I guess I have two Teferi, so... Let's see, what else is my hand doing? I want to get maybe white-green here. They have Fury, so if I minus, they can kill it. If I plus, I forget how they win if I plus there. If I minus, I kill a token, they would have to Fury and have a land and have a glimpse. I'm just gonna plus for now and hope I'm not missing something. I guess I could have gone back to real quick. Too late now, I guess, but let's see. Glimpse. That nice draw too. If they had the turn free glimpse, they would have the kind of perfect draw garden into Wavesifter into Glimpse. All right, let's see. Start by exploring. I guess I'll just keep plussing. Can't really down take on the clue. Could down take on the plant token. Like Omnath coming my way. Skyclave gonna be pretty good for me here. All right, Temeshi. I don't really want to let them untap with an Omnath though. It's all scary. All right, I think I'm gonna start choosing my Teferi. Let me get rid of Omnath. Maybe it's a little weak. I could just finale for engineer and then go off next turn. Getting all punished here. My decision. I might just bounce my Skyclave next turn and then play another Teferi. Skyclave Omnath. Kind of have to. What are they using the mana for? Fury? I feel like if they have Fury, they would have just pitched Fury, killed Teferi, and then cast a Glimpse, cascaded into a Glimpse. Oh, Season Pyro. Let's see. Kind of slightly dug myself into a corner. So I'll just let them have Omnath. Try my own Omnath. Plan is just to chump, I guess. I don't want to bounce Omnath. I don't want to give them more draw steps. I don't think so. All right, not the greatest deal to lose a land here. Not gonna end up mattering. As long as they don't have Fury. I think they should have four Furies, but maybe not. I also just hard cast the Goblin card. So they can like hard cast the Goblin card, kill my Teferi, and then have mana to Glimpse. Yeah, I should have just kept ticking up Teferi, play Temeshi, combo them turn after that. Let's see. That's pretty bad for me. I don't even know what I was scared of, honestly. Oh well. They don't have Fury in their deck. I mean, they might not be able to kill me. They're gonna be able to put their entire deck in play, but
I mean, they've got a Fury, right? I'm kind of pissed. Here's a Fury. Can I still win? I don't think I can still win. Can I go off? Wargate. Wargate for Lotus, Finale for Thingy. I don't know, I kind of misplayed this game, but also Finale, getting stuck with Finale in hand was kind of my point. Let's see, Meddling Mage and Lavinia both seem good. Deputy could be okay too if I feel like some of my other cards are worse. It gives me a removal, extra removal. So I usually just trim some top end. Something like this looks good. Maybe Deputy or Skyclave. Because it's better utility in the early game. Get the clue tokens from the wave sifter. I don't think the ley lines do anything for me. Should be a good matchup, I think. Maybe I should have Skyclave too. They could have their own ley lines. Yeah, I should just have both. Skyclave's so mediocre. I have Deputy, I have two Baseju, two Otawaro. Mean, I could still see playing one. I don't mind one Finale of Devastation, especially for ease of execution on Magic Online. But I'm pretty sure the second one's just Ley Line and this. Okay. Pretty good start. It's not a big deal, though. Ley Line's. I'm not even sure you should bring in Leyline in this matchup, even if you do have it. It's just incredibly mediocre. Just so easy to deal with. Let's see. So I should maybe get Stomping Ground just in case. Pretty good spot here. I can Teferi minus on the Goblin token next turn. Was looking good in game one, too, and I found a way. Oh, there's a Wargate. Not a very good showing for the second Otawara so far. I'm not even sure I was playing the first Otawara. I think I was, but I'm kind of low on these lands. No, I had the first Otawara and the first Baseju. Okay. Plus. I could, I think just playing Nodder, Teferi, and plussing is fine. gonna tutor for Tameshi. Hopefully they just step out for like Omnath or something, so. And I guess I have Teferi and Platicus is gonna be clear no matter what. Only card that can mess with you is actually Odawara. Shroudless Agent. Bonds the ley line. Get a lotus. Sometimes people scoop at this point when they shouldn't. Because they think it's just over, but really I could just not have anything. In this case, obviously do have something. I guess turn timber is really good in that spot, right? You just bounce it and... Huh, I never even thought about that. Weird. Yeah, turn timber is really good. I guess turn timber is yet another reason to, to not play so many finales, because it gives you even more more consistency, etc. Is one finale, how much mana do I have? 7, 10. Let's play Grazer. Put the land back into play tapped. Do it one more time. And cast finale for... Actually, they have blockers. Hopefully they're just scoop here. If they've seen the deck in action, they know the writing is super on the wall. Annoying. I can't kill them right away. Oh no, I am done. I can just bounce the token. Alright, let's not waste time. You could have given me the cards they scoop. I scooped them last game. I didn't make them go through the motions. Maybe it's the first time they see the deck. Alright, we saw Leyline confirmed, so do I want the extra Skyclave? It's not bad, like getting rid of an Omnath too if the game's a little slow could be fine. So yeah, I don't think you want to trim Wargate. I'll trim Wargate in mashups against people who have Teferi in their deck. No, it's the other way around. I'll trim Lotus Bloom in these matchups. I don't need Skyclave. I have two Odawara, two Aseju. Alright. Man, I can't believe I spewed the Grazer Teferi draw in game one. I don't have the most exciting hand, but I do have a turn 4 kill. Was Odawara to potentially bounce a ley line, so kind of a fairly clean turn 4 kill. And I'm not sure how well that version mulligans without Renin 6. They took a mulligan too, which I don't think should play a huge factor in your decision, but they're a little less likely to have a busted hand. I don't think I'm ever gonna have time to. Oh my god, I have sixed. I have six and called myself was F5. Oh jeez. Almost had a heart attack. That would end bad. A little explore would be nice here. Just have Odawara one turn earlier. As they still get two turn free glamps if they have it. Aversion's it's more consistent, but it's not as scary as a version trying maybe to put Archons into play and whatnot. Red, green, white, blue. Maybe I should still use my fetch lands though. Just gonna fin the deck. No Chalice in this version. That might have been a good game to Chalice for zero. All right, a little scary. Teferi. Teferi's one time. Demry's Call. I mean, there's nothing good I can call for, right? I have Grazer. Nothing I can wargate for either. Right, the question is, should I call for a Grazer? Could like. I don't think calling for Grazer makes a ton of sense. I'm trying to think. Think maybe just calling for Temeshi's just better. How can they stop me? All right, let me take one more look at what I used to play. Where are you, Glimpse? Glimpse Omnia. They could have disputes. Have endurance. They could have. Could flip a ley line into play. That's something I need to be worried about. They could flip a black ley line into play. Meaning, maybe just Wargate for Lotus is what. But then it gives them like kind of a sitting duck target. Could Wargate for. No, I was gonna say I could Wargate for a land. Yeah, I think just calling for Temeshi is my best bet. Casting Outburst, one floating. Even better. All right, well, the good news is They don't have more lands, so I think I'm actually gonna be fine here. Think that's just game over. Oh. How unbearably unlucky. I mean, you're playing Glimpse of Tomorrow. You know what you sign up for. But that was pretty unlucky. They probably had another Cascade spell in hand. They needed just two lands out of, I don't know, seven. How many hits? Not sure, a lot. Oh, you don't even have to do that. Only triggers once. That's Barrence, I guess. Yeah, I mean, don't want to say anything, but, well, I said something here, but not in chat. When you play the full RNG deck, can't really complain too much. Get a Colossus. All right, not the craziest Colossus, but it literally doesn't matter at this point. Could have had like endurance at some point to mess with me. Right, actually, oh yeah, I can play Grazer for, I think Grazer maybe nets you one mana. This way I can Wargate was, or 7 was one white up. Okay. They have double dispute in hand. Like, rough. Really thinking cool story, but no, I mean, I sympathize. I sympathize. I've played the Glimpse deck before. I've been there. I've had to like horrendous luck. I guess Explorer like is pretty cool in that spot. It really doesn't matter, honestly. Like Explorer or not, but more cute than anything at this point. Let's see, let's see. I mean, they could have forced some negation, I doubt it. No, I don't want to kill both my Colossus, that does not seem smart. Alright, I guess they're making me work for it a bit. Alright, it's always nice to start with a win. Of course, the video is brought to you by Channel Fireball and Ultimate Guard. ChannelFireball.com is a marketplace. You can go there, buy cards from hundreds of local game stores. You get to shop for the best price or support your local game store. You can use my code YellowHat at checkout, that helps me out. They have Magic cards, also Flesh and Blood. Yu-Gi-Oh! bunch of games. You can find it all, huge marketplace. So definitely check channelfireball.com out. Give me a second. I have Temeshi, I have a Wargate, I have some lands, I have the Colossus, sure. Just play turn Timber Tap, turn one. Save some life. But yeah. There's also Channel Fireball Pro, CFB Pro. It's premium content. There's some free part of the website where you can check out mostly deck highlights, kind of shorter articles. And then CFB Pro is the premium content. And you have a couple different offers. There's a monthly fee that gets you the content, which is mostly deck guides, in-depth deck guides for pretty much every major archetype in every competitive format. And you also have an offer that's more expensive, but you get your money back in store credit, meaning that if you're going to buy cards on Channel Fireball, you can basically get yourself Channel CFB Pro for free. So that's pretty cool. Just check out CFB Pro on the website or Google CFB Pro. Pretty easy to find. And of course, our amazing sponsor and partner, Ultimate Guard, they have some of the best deck boxes, best sleeves in the business. Really, really top-notch top-notch product, quality, always coming up with new designs. They also have a brand new website. What am I even doing here? I already have a Temeshi. What are they playing? Blue White, Spreading Seas, No Yorion. Huh. I'm actually not sure. I already have a Colossus, I already have a Temeshi. Can get the Lotus Loom next turn. Just get a backup Temeshi in case they have Solitude, I think, is probably the best. Oh my, oh no, okay. I haven't lost my mind quite yet. I think maybe Lotus Bloom and just cast the Temeshi now? But yeah, Ultimate Guard has a brand new website, ultimateguard.com. Well, not brand new, but they revamped it. Now, if you live in Europe, you can buy cards directly on the website. If you're in the US, I think it still goes through Amazon. But yeah, huge improvement for Europeans who want to get themselves some sweet deck boxes, sleeves, and whatnot. And they also have a blog part. I actually had the honor of being the first featured writer. I wrote about kind of strategic content, the mana base in deck building. So yeah, if that's something you might be interested in, check out ultimateguard.com and go check out the blog section. They did a really nice job to just the way it looks. We all have little intros, you know, kind of little bios for me and the rest of the team, Mengu, LSV, Gabi, etc. And I thought they did a really good job anyways. All right, main phase Solitude, they pitched a verdict. I sing a land. Ooh, that's nice draw. Should I get more green and white maybe? Sorry. Let's have a backup of the backup. I'm just gonna play tonight to make sure I would just maximize mana. Looks like they might just be blue-white controlled, but they drew their one basic planes. Just kind of mana screw draw of blue-white control. So they need Teferi here. What do they need? Teferi, Nutter Solitude. Pitch Teferi stuck on two lands. A little unlucky there. It seems like blue-white control should be a bad matchup for this deck, but I've been beating it. I've been in the leagues, I've been in good players and challenges too. I think this should just be... Right, so maybe I should have gotten Hallowed Fountain. Alright, better lucky than good. Let's see if they have... I think they only play two Solitudes. If they're playing the latest list from the challenge. Monsieur Cafouillette, who always plays Blood Control, who's a... One for Tapa's good friend won the Modern Challenge on Sunday. So here you have two options. You can play the first Colossus for... I think in that spot I'm okay. If you're a little tight, it's sometimes better to bounce the last land. It means your Colossus is gonna die when you cast it, but you get that extra mana and that extra draw step, which can be a big deal when you feel like you might be short on resources. But this game, it was like not especially close. All right, I want Defense Grid. I want maybe the Hate Bears. I think Grazer can probably go. So Teferi is kind of a problem in this matchup. What I like to do against people who have Teferi is to trim a Lotus Bloom, which is a little annoying because turn one Lotus Bloom is obviously what you're looking for. But yeah, I like to trim... And then I think I still like to trim a bit of maybe top end. Maybe a finale. You can trim a Colossus too, because they have Dresdown. Dresdown's actually pretty nasty against you. And then I guess I'll do Deputy, even though I kind of hate it against control decks. This is mostly for Solitude, but I have Defense Grid for that. So I don't think I need that. And then Meddling Mage, mostly for Teferi, could be worth it. What should my last card be? Maybe just an Explore. I did got two grazers, so maybe I could cut a land. I don't hate it. All right, we got everything. We got defense grids. I should play Fetch Land turn one because of Spreading Seas. So I have green, so I need to get blue white. Was that? Let's go ahead and get headquarters. And so here it's kind of interesting. I could say go, kind of tax their mana a bit, or I could start jamming. I could also explore. Let's see. If I explore now and it resolves. If I draw, if they go to fairy plus and I draw good color and mana, I can go Wargate for Lotus. Lotus, 8 mana. Sorry. 3/4, get a Lotus. So I'll have 4 lands in play. That's only 8 mana. Cast Torrent Timber, but might not be good enough. Cast Call, but I'm 1 short to cast Colossus. Still feel like Explore is probably the play here. Didn't think about countering it. I don't have to go nuts, nuts with Temeshi. I can just go like get a Lotus Bloom, cast Temeshi, bring it back, draw just one card, play a defense grid. But they're drawing right away. I guess they worry about like Skyclave or something. I think that's the line, right? So decisions, decisions here. Well, I guess we'll see first if Depth Solitude. Depth Solitude is kind of a moot point. So I can cast Grid now, but it means that next turn I can go call for Temeshi, cast Temeshi. If I save the grid, next turn I can go grid and I'm still 1 mana short. So maybe just play the grid now. Then they have Prismatic Ending and stuff. Kind of want to save the grid for the turn I go off. Let's see. I actually don't have red mana. Could counter, they could keep mana for solitude. They just have a counter and a solitude. They might just let it resolve. This way they can pay the free mana for solitude if I try to go off with Temeshi. Counter, it's not a bad result for me. So now I can call play Temeshi, but then I'm out of Temeshi. And I'm vulnerable to removal spell and verdict. Or I can play Engineer. Tutor for Temeshi. What's more likely that they have another counter? They don't have that many counters. They're just more likely to have some kind of removal spell, I think. Goblin Engineer doesn't do a ton here. But I guess you fin your deck. Something. Maybe I should have played a different order in case they have Spell Pierce. Like the blue-white deck doesn't have an overwhelming amount of card advantage, though. Like every time, like that sequence, for instance, the Temeshi getting my Lotus Bloom, they had to 2-for-1 myself, and I replaced Temeshi, so it's basically 3-for-1, 2-for-0, however you want to call it. Add another Teferi. Wait, what? Why would you minus on Engineer? Engineer doesn't do anything. Well, that was really weird. As a Fence Grid, I didn't even think about that. Defense Grid to Mio. That's pretty cool. We found the War Gates. All right. Yeah, I don't know why they didn't just plus. I mean, I was gonna go for it anyways, but that might be one of these spots where you go full value as a first Colossus. I'm not sure yet. Let's see. Let's see what it looks like. Yeah. Did I play a land yet? I have. So yeah, this is like one of these spots where you're okay letting your first Colossus die. They might scoop last game in that same spot. The craziest amount of lands. They'd find another War Gate though. So should be more than good. Think in all the games I've played when I've cast a Colossus like that, I'm not even sure I've lost one. I think maybe it came close like once or twice. Okay. Not sure my fans want to see the whole combo again, but it's fine. Like at this point, even if I don't like completely go off, it's I'm gonna have like defense grids in play, I'm gonna have a bunch of creatures in play. Okay. Let's get Teferi in play. I mean, I could even just bounce Colossus. I'll play a defense grid. Because why not? Really hoping to get the memo. I'm dumb. I should have just told them, play Scoop. But I guess, good to know what to do in these spots, even though it's pretty straightforward. Let's see. I'm gonna bounce my Colossus. Let's do a bit more mana just in case. Can't hurt. Just need to be careful not to deck, but you'd have to like basically do it by mistake. Okay, where's that finale? Still not. Sure. Okay. I'm done. For my fans, eh? What I like to do, if you're a bit like me and you're a bit scared, is I like to like make sure I can, even if I misclick somewhere, I still have the Lotus in play. I'm not gonna get Colossus. Search library, sure. Engineer, come here, buddy. No. This way, even if you mess up, you still have like a Lotus and post-combat, you can like replay a bunch of stuff. GG's, this was definitely close one, yeah. Somehow the blue-white matchups, I don't know, I've been winning. I feel like they always stumble somewhere. They never have the perfect like counter into Teferi's Solitude. And even when they have that stuff, you still have some kind of game. Back at it. Of course, if you like the content, I usually wait till the very end of the video to say that stuff, which is maybe not super useful, but yeah. Leaving a like helps us a lot. If you want to see more, you can subscribe to the channel. You can leave a comment. If you have a question, I usually check the comments once a week after the league was posted. Question about the deck. If you want to, leave a comment, meme about speed of play, the huge, feel free. Okay, interesting hand here. It's not missing much. It actually doesn't look great, but I think this hand's perfectly fine. I just need to draw one of my tutors for question is what do I do here? Sacred Fire into Force into Engineer or play? I think I should keep the garden, right? Just because I have I could get flooded. Or is a Saga? Is it Amulet Titan? The Amulet, oh, Springleaf Drum. Some mono blue list. There's a few. It might be mono blue. Might be a little tough. The other version, I just play Kotaki in my sideboard. Ooh. Kind of nasty. And I think I messed up. Yeah, I don't have red mana. That is all loose to not play minus two life. Definitely not letting them draw off Sentinel in that spot. It's not true. I said I was only one tutor off. I'm one tutor off and then one Colossus off, but I still think this hand is fine. Explorer looking much better than Ren and Six in this specific hand. It's gonna say a bit of a slow start, but no, they're just gonna make a token and things are gonna get nasty. All right, what now? It's not that I'm here, I actually want to play the garden. Yeah, Turn Timber is a weird one. I'm not sold. Like, seven cards is not that many, especially to find a Colossus, and it's super RNG. You'd rather not have to rely on that. Let's see if they have a Needle in their main deck. Needle would be pretty good for them here. Needle on Temeshi. Another drum. I just noticed they're playing mono white. Are they just hammer? They're just hammer time. For some reason, I thought it was an artifact deck, but yeah, it's just hammer time. That's a lot of damage. I'll just block now before both their Giver of Runes are online. Blue, red, green. Okay. It's actually not too bad. Only cost me 3 mana. I think I want to do it now. Temple Garden tapped. Just use Ottawara to bounce one of the tokens. Since it doesn't seem like they're doing much of the actual hammer time thing this game, just gonna buy me a lot of time. All right, let's see it. I was bad mouthing Turn Timber like literally a second ago. Let's see if I can hit anything sweet. Uh-oh, they played the hammer. Why would you ever play the hammer first? Oh, I'm dumb. Extra power on now. All right, let's see it. I can pay here. As long as I keep white mana up. Let's see if we hit a Temeshi. We do, that's actually 5-6 Temeshi too. Pretty cool here, I get to balance the garden. Give me a cycling land down the line. Teferi, Teferi, what does Teferi do for me? Not a ton, honestly. I don't think I'm in much danger of dying. Well, that's not true, actually. It can protect each other. Bouncing hammer does nothing for me. Yeah, I guess I'm just gonna say go. I am dead to Pure Sealed Paladin. But there's nothing I can do about it. That's not it. Do they have Nettle Cyst? Do they have 7 mana one. The reality chip, ooh. Can't equip it right away. But I probably just lose next turn. I think next turn I can probably easily win. I have a lot of redraws. A lot of redraws. Okay. Let's see. Start by fetching, maybe. Spin the deck. Oh. What's the most efficient? Well, I should at least do that first. Bounce a cycling land, draw cards, another Temeshi. Let's play Teferi first. Right. I think I'll pay. Could be a mistake. I think I have enough mana to pay. Bounce the Utter Giver. They'll at least slow them down a bit. Because I have what? I have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 13, 16, 19. 19 mana. Because now it's 3 mana since the land is untapped to start with. So, okay, 3 mana per. So I guess let's say we're am I ever gonna brick? I don't think so. I'll do one more land. Okay, let's do Turn Timber. Okay, Turn Timber was pretty good this game, I'll say. Turn Timber was clutch. And that's game. Hopefully they know that's game, yeah. Turn Timber was giga clutch. Especially the first one. Here, I mean, I had Teferi, I had Temeshi, I had ways to draw a few more cards. Alright, Deputy's probably good. Meddling Mage. Could be good on Hammer. Lavinia. Doesn't really do much. What's bad against them? Explorer is a little sketch because of Sentinel. Finale, I think, can basically almost always cut. They have Teferi in the blue version. But I don't know if they're the blue version. We saw Reality Chip, but we didn't see blue lands. Yeah, just simple, I guess. Oh, I said maybe Meddling Mage. I'll bring in Meddling Mage. I think Meddling Mage could be good on two, just naming Teferi, Hammer, Pure Soul Paladin, depending on their draw. Cheap creatures are at a premium against Esper Sentinel. It's the reason I like to leave in Ragavan when I play against Hammer Time, even when I'm on the draw. Just give them something to worry about that's cheap that you can curve out, you know, used to curve out. Man, Temeshi Boom's such a cool deck. Just so cool, like everything comes together. So what do I like so far? I liked everything so far. Not 100% sold on second Besseju, second Autowara, but you have to see, it's not like just, oh, I lost another war, it's, did it lose me the game? Probably not. And when it bounced a keeper in, did it win me the game? So it's not easy to keep track, but... Because for instance, I mean, so far this league I've had to sag the Ottawa a bunch, but did it actually lose me the game? No, and it was pretty clutch a couple times. They go first, they draw seven. I don't have Lotus Bloom in my opening hand. I have a really slow hand. I don't have a Grazer. I think this is actually a mulligan, despite the fact I have a lot of the combo pieces much better. I get Bloom, I got Tameshi, I got Finale. Tricky. I think maybe it's just Omnath. Slam. Oh, I guess they're playing. So they are playing the blue version. No, they got basic planes. I don't know. A turn one. Okay. And Memnite. Grazer. Play one of my turn timbers to go. I think you can cast every spell in the deck if you play. Let's see, are they just gonna have a dummy like hammer 11-11? I'm gonna lose to that. Okay, I get one extra turn. Could be the difference between winning and losing. I'm still dead on board right now. I need to draw a Grazer. Nope. Can I finale? I can finale for a Grazer next turn. That might actually be that'd be sick if that's how finale won me the game. They could have Spell Pierce, which wins them the game. They could have just a Teferi next turn, probably more than good enough. Okay, well, then they have the second hammer. Who does have a removal for my Grazer? Kind of funny. Clutch. Clutch Grazer. Put Flooded Strain in play because it gets basic planes. Teferi, Teffers, GG. Doesn't look like it. Taking them a while to play it if they have it. Hammer is game, Teferi is game, and that's game. Well, a bit of a slow roll there, it feels like, but. Shadow Spear? Fancy. I don't know if they're playing around anything or just messing with me. All right. They're on the play. That pretty solid draw. Glad I mulliganed that first hand at least. Tuck, tuck, tuck. On the play, Explore doesn't get necessarily much better. Yeah, looks good. I like my chances on the play. They are playing the blue version, not just a reality chip. It is a more common version, this version splashing for Teferi, Spell Pierce, and whatnot. But the mono white version's been putting up. I mean, it's hard to know. You just see the results, who does really well. You don't see how many people play each version, and you don't have the win rates. But in top 8 of challenges, I've seen both the blue white versions and the mono white version, even though the blue white version's more popular. I think way more popular. I've been really impressed by the blue cards anyways. The chip, Teferi. Grazer doesn't work with Storm Timber. I'm not a Titan player, so I'm not super used to that card. Yeah, I kind of like the more focused approach, explore over Ren. You don't really miss Ren, you don't really run out of gas, and you have Turn Timber to make up for like some of the floods. I wasn't like super sold on the second Omnath in the first place. I think one is just fine. Skyclave. We have to see. The tracker, the one tracker was really good for me in the other list. I like Grazer. Yeah. No, Turn Timber kind of maybe ties the deck together, lets you play more lands and Grazer and makes Grazer better, makes Explore better. All right, they are deep in the tank. Got the Lotus in the opening hand. I've got Grazer. I've got my own Teferi. It looks like a pretty great hand. So I need to play Turn Timber, right? I guess either way, huh? Can I save the life at some point? F call. What am I worried about? I'm worried about turn three Teferi. You may put the land card for your hand. So if I get basic forest, fetch land, get Hallowed Fount. All right, I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do. I'm sure pretty much anything works. Anything goes. Boo-doo, boo-doo, boo-boo, boo. Oh, that's kind of nasty, actually. I was gonna turn to Teferi, bounce the Saga too. I mean, you got an end Windswept Heath, right? Lotus Bloom is cool and all, but yeah. I don't really have Sigadar's Aid. Yeah, that makes sense because they played Saga. Man, I really need to draw. I'd have another. They have a hammer ready in hand. I guess I just messed up. Maybe I was supposed to take that one hit. I mean, I should get Temeshi maybe, because at least I can cast it if I brick. What else can I cast? I have green, green, blue or white. Green, blue or white. Yeah, so it's just Temeshi. Come on, land. Oh, it's the second Windswept Heath. I got so excited. I'm just dead. I mean, I think I was pretty dead either way. I would have had to play Temeshi, chomp, and then hope to draw Temeshi next turn. Wow, insane. I got so excited that I drew a land and it was Windswept Heath. All like this. Who knows? I mean, I get Lotus, I have 6 mana. Hopefully it lets me rabbit hunt. The Hammer Time Curse. Anytime I get paired against Hammer Time, I find a way to lose. Usually combination of bad luck and bad plays, just like here. That's kind of gross. Please let me rabbit hunt. So my draw was a Teferi. Yeah, I mean, maybe I bounce Ornithopter and it's good enough. They didn't have much going on, honestly. Man. All right, I'll be right back. Damn. Oh, the grazer block was also bad. Even though if I don't block, I guess they can maybe get Shadow Spear if they left it in, but it's not. I don't know if they left it in. I wasn't sure what was happening. What do you mean? All right. Good hand. A little slow because I don't have Grazer or Explore, but pretty robust. Mono black coffers. Wow, that might be a really tough matchup if they're still playing Karn. I think the latest lists I've seen actually have not had Karn in them, though. I guess I'll play the engineer now and see what happens. And I can Wargate for another Lotus. Please have Skyclave to get rid of Karn in this version. It's kind of nice. Bajuka bug. See, that was kind of good. It like kind of baited them into getting a Bajuka bug. So that's kind of value. I'm happy about that. Let's see if they take the Wargate now. No, they didn't. They have another discard spell, maybe. Okay, they're kind of spewing their spells. They might not be super familiar with the deck. But I don't think what they're doing is super great right now. I don't know, we'll see. We're gonna get the Lotus. Maybe they play Karn. I'll have to tutor for Skyclave and hope that's not too slow. They also get to kill the Lotus right away if they do have Karn. But yeah, it's kind of fine. Kind of discard the Explore. I like keeping my lands against Liliana, I guess. Grazer doesn't do anything for us. Just play fetch, say. Oh, wait! Why say go? What am I doing? Let's see if we get the freebie scoop. I doubt it. I think Grazer might actually be really good. Or pretty good at least. Omnath. Let's see. Play Grazer. Green, white, blue, reds. Play with Seju, this way I have it in play. I can discard if they go plus again, I can discard planes. Let's see what they have. Do they have Karn? Invoke Golos. Okay. Doesn't do much. All right, we're in a pretty good spot. We get to untap with Temeshi, cast an Omnath, so I'm gonna generate a lot of value. And I'm not even sure they quite have the mana yet for Cataracts. Yeah, the best one was Urborg. Teferi, okay. So what now? Let's see. I guess Slade was on there. Green, white, blue, red. Get to like nuke the. Nuke the Liliana. Replay with Seju. Play an explore. Play a fetch land, very nice. This way I get the Omnath trigger. Get a basic, why not? All right, this is where we need to think about things for a second. I could bounce Omnath. I'm not gonna be able to trigger it again. I could bounce Temeshi. Don't wanna bounce Golos. Well, I could bounce Golos and attack Liliana. They have no cards in hand. But then I give them an out over a couple turns, so that's not great. Oh, I can just Bossage you. Oh, okay, let's cast Teferi. Let's Bossage you. That's pretty cool. Duh. All right, people in chat yelling at me, Gab. All right, I'm gonna bounce the. Probably messed up with the mana. Should have had a blue or white floating. Guess I'll just plus. And give them a draw step. What I could have done is maybe if I had a white or a blue floating. I'm not sure if that was even possible. I could have I guess I didn't want to bounce my Tamisha on a real to attack. Too good, what? Could have Sorin. Could have Sorin? What are they talking about? It's 7 mana. I actually drew Karn, but now I have a board presence. I don't care that much. What can they get? I mean, whatever they get, I can bounce. Unless another Golos actually would be annoying. It's another Golos, I can just, No, I don't have a target for Tamish anymore. Oh, Chef sagged the Lotus in response. That was a big mistake. Wow. Making the mistake so you don't have to. One card I really liked in this deck was the one bubble I was playing. Just tons of synergies with the fetch land and with Temeshi. It gives you these few extra hits with Temeshi, the creator and the bubble. It doesn't seem like much, but it adds up in some of the grindy games and just having kind of critical mass of cards you can bring back with Temeshi is nice. Bolas Citadel. Well, that's scary. I don't think they're the greatest Bolas Citadel deck ever, though. We'll see. Doesn't strike me. Love their cheap stuff. His discard spell. They have a lot of lands. They have a lot of expensive cards. Fatal Push. It was the president asking if Explore is better than Ren and Six in Temeshi Bloom. Told him it was pretty good. Pretty good so far. Alright. Now what? Just tag them? No, what am I talking about? Attack Karn, attack them. Make sure there's no funny business. Let's cast a Turn Timber, see what I hit. Colossus, the greatest Colossus. Oh, I mean, I guess I don't want to bounce all the lands because if I don't hit a Colossus, it's bad, but all right, that's all loose. Actually, I have Teferi. I can just go again. Okay, this is the spots where you're kind of hoping for your opponent's scoop because you're just never losing that game in a million years. Have I played a land yet this turn? I'm not even sure I have. Okay. Once my Colossus, cast it again. Value, value, value. No, no, no. Without Ren and with one less real land, it is like a little. You go. I feel like I've been not going off as much, but. Alright, let's just. No, never mind. I should keep going. Make sure I have, like, overwhelming advantage. Actually, that's probably good enough, right? Alright, I'll do it one more. One more time. Actually, give me a sec. Do I have another Teferi? I can just kill them this turn. If I find another Teferi, I can bounce on that, put a bunch of lands in play. Oh, it might take too long though. Alright, I could kill them this turn, but I'm just not gonna bother. There's just no way I'm losing this game. Gonna suspend that. Gonna explore. Put turn timber in play. If you left, no. I'm just gonna keep everything in hand. Okay, cool. Opponent, what you got? All right. I'm joking right now, but this is not a good matchup. I'd be surprised if I ended up losing the match anyways. I'm just bringing Meddling Mage and Deputy. And the Ley Lines of Sanctity? There are a lot of discard spells. I think I need to. Let's see. I'll do what I usually do. Maybe cut a Lotus Bloom. Keep the answer Sukarn. Keep value targets. Grazer for Liliana Minus and for some nutted hands. Grazers and Leyline seems like a lot. I'm just going to board out the Grazers. Do you have two Odawaras for Karn? Is Deputy just too bad against them? Deputy might just be too bad of an answer. Not sure. I don't want to cut an explorer. I'll just cut a land, I guess. And so tough. Got a Lotus Womb. Last Thursday. I don't know what they are, but I have no idea what's going on. They seem to be in a little old world here. I have a Ley Line, I have a Teferi. Not much else. Kind of want to keep. I'll just keep. I think it's kind of a tough matchup. I have exactly one Ley Line in my opening hand. And if I draw a few lands, could be good with Teferi. Kind of gamblish. If they had Mulligan, maybe I'd Mulligan. Voidwalker. It's another fun one. Yep. This matchup is a pain. Like a boss. I guess I'm just gonna buy a little time. Not much I can do. How do I piece so in together here? Could just like this is getting awkward. I can tutor up for a Lotus and then just hard cast Colossus and hope that's good enough somehow. I can't imagine it's gonna be. Just lead with Meddling Mage, like Meddling Mage on Khan or something. That's bad. I think this game's over. Just horrendous matchup. I'm just gonna close chat because I don't want them to keep saying and see anything really weird on screen and just getting a little uncomfortable. I guess I could have the chat closed and ignore chat. Show game log. That also works. All right, their turn to spin the wheel. I sideboard a bit differently, maybe. Let's bring in Deputy. Forgot about Voidwalker. Bring Deputy and maybe have all the Lotuses on the play. I mean, technically, if I get insanely lucky, if my top cards are Temeshi plus untapped lands, I can go off. Oh, that's good for me. They're getting a little fancy fancy. Teferi. Wow, and it targeted Lotus and I had F6'd. Oh man, you're kind of like messing up, and I was F6'd. Oh, that was such a bad play by them. Well, my treat. Ah, I'm so frustrated. I gave them an extra draw step. I mean, I guess it's not the, it's like, I just gave them an extra draw step, basically. I'll scoop to literally anything like relevant. I mean, you can get unlucky with Golos. I do have a ley line in play. I don't have creatures. They have like a bunch of expedition maps and lands. Karn is not a break though. Alright, that's the nail in the coffin. Meddling Mage is maybe not that great. They have a lot of ways to get rid of it. Could maybe cut Leyline. Now that they've seen them, they might go lower on discard spells. Stops slowly down a minus two. Alright, I'll do something pretty similar, but just two ley lines. One lander again. That sounds just bad. Rip. Oh well. Tough matchup. Tough matchup, tough draws. Okay. I think I should keep back up to Meshki, right? Oh. I'm gonna play it now. What should I play it on though? Just Voidwalker, I guess. Right, if I draw land next turn, I'm in a decent spot, I guess. Maybe. Depends. I kind of have the good start. Man, do they just not have discard spells? Come on, land. Oh my god, it's not like this. Mean, I don't have the payoff yet anyway, so I guess it's not that big of a deal that I'm not making my land drops because I don't need the mana for anything right now. Good thing to explore there if they don't have much going on. Fetch land, potentially fatal push. Trying to think if I should play my planes first. Don't think I need to. Let's bounce the cycling land in case I flood a bit. Yeah. So close. Can a Wargate or two? Should I just play the garden? Yeah. Need to play the garden and just hope they have nothing. I've played a land already, right? Yeah. Man, I could hit. Nah, it's just too bad. I just have to hope they don't have Karn. Liliana's fine-ish. Karn is not. Profane Tutor. Profane Tutor go. Oh, amazing. Yeah, just get Temeshi again. Just so much value. Could get Omnath, I guess. What now, though? Which land do I bounce? I've already played a land. Bounce with Seju for now. I mean, the cycling one is nice to balance because they destroy a Lotus with something, I get to cycle. Alright, next turn I lose. Maybe this turn I lose, but the tutor. Oh, I have to pay for the tutor. Eight mana. Archon. Okay, I mean, it's not the end of the world. Can still win. It's now or never. Whew. So what's the play here? How much mana can I generate? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. So if I bounce, I have 1, 6, 8, 10 mana, I think, available to me. So if I bounce the Mishi and cast it again, that costs me 3, that leaves me with 7. I think it's better than bouncing Archon. Bouncing Archon doesn't do anything for me. No good. Not sure what I'm supposed to do here. They lose their Profane Tutor to my Teferi. I take a big hit. They draw a bunch of cards. I play Temeshi now, they just have so many ways to get rid of it. What about bouncing something? Casting Temeshi, bouncing Teferi, playing it again. Doesn't really help me. I think I'm just supposed to say go here. Can discard the Lotus to Archon, that's kind of nice. Also nod that to another Archon, which is also nice. Because that's a card they could have in hand. Discard spell is going to be really hard to beat. Yes, stupid Golos. No. Oh. All right, game is incredibly hard. Might just be unwinnable, actually. I don't think I have outs. I'm just dead. All right, GG's. That matchup's just incredibly hard. Pretty fringe matchup, but what a nightmare. What a freaking nightmare. Right. Still a pretty good showing, honestly. Blue White Hammer Tom was kind of close. Maybe I could have played a bit better. This was just kind of your worst possible matchup, I think, honestly. Nothing else comes to mind right now that would be worse. The Murktide matchup's been good for me. The Blue-White Control matchup's been good for me. Oh, 4-color Omnath is tough. Because they have Teferi, which is one of the best cards against you. Like, the hate cards like Leyline, Rest in Peace, Removal, all that's... It's not that big of a deal. Teferi, Time Raveler is pretty obnoxious. And they have Solitude, they have Decent Pressure. They have, like, Endurance and stuff. I don't know, I played that matchup, and that matchup felt pretty tough. They can have Counter Spells. They have Bolts for your thingy and cheap removal. They have Bolt for Tameshi, pretty well rounded against you. But I think that black matchup's got to be like 1,000 times worse. Grummart. Yeah, hands just fine. I think I can maybe play Turn Timber, Turn 1 in case there's some kind of aggressive deck. The man has worked. I haven't really missed Basic Owl in this league. You're actually not that bad against Blood Moon because of Lotus Bloom. You just need Lotus Bloom and then you need one of, you know, your basic planes, I guess. And then you're all set to combo off. But yeah, if you like the content, make sure you leave a comment. If you saw me, if you have a question, feel free to ask. If you saw me make maybe a bad play at some point, you know, feel free to point it out as well. And if you want to support the content, you can subscribe to the channel, leave a like. You can check out our sponsors, channelfireball.com, as well as... Is that a mirror match? Might be a mirror match. As well as Ultimate Guard. Ultimate Guard has a brand new website as well, making it super easy if you live in Europe to order deck boxes and sleeves and all their product. And they also have a blog section, was a blog written by the whole pro team. That's me, LSV, Gavi, Minguchi, Chuza, Reed. I think I'm sure I forgot someone. Did I have Suspended Lotus, by the way? No. Yeah, we're playing a mirror match. Should I have played Tameshi in the mirror match? They bounce Tameshi, they bounce Lotus is the same thing. It's better if I, probably better like that, because then at least they don't get to draw. All right, can I pop off? I don't think so. I can generate 8 mana. How much mana does Explore buy you? Does Explore buy you like 1 mana? I mean, either way, I can... Can at least do that. Bring back Lotus. Let's do that and go from there. Could go for a turn timber play, but if I break, I just lose. Let's see what I draw. Maybe I'll get lucky. Okay, maybe I have the mana now. Oh god, this is gonna take a while. Free mana. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Why am I already up to 9? Grazer, I think Grazer and... Alright. No, I should really think it through. So, 3 mana, pay 1, bounce, 5, 4, 6, 5, 8 mana, Grazer, 7 mana, pay 1, 6 mana, Lotus, 9 mana, explore 7 mana, put an untapped land, 8 mana. Alright, I think I can go off. Well, if not, I'm going down in flames. Comes into play tapped anyways. Explorer comes into play untapped. Let's see. Okay, so it's one of these games where you have to do full Val, but that's fine. Have the one white up, that's what we care about. Let's see if they do me the courtesy of scooping. Okay, it's nice that we're hitting these two extra lands. Could use the help. Kind of a little awkward there. Maybe they're just a little laggy or a little FK. Good thing someone who plays the deck would be the first person to scoop, but that they know you just don't fizzle. I feel like a broken record talking about that stuff every time. All right, mirror match. So as I said, I think ley lines are pretty crappy, so I'm not gonna bother. Defense grid does nothing. Meddling Mage is symmetrical. Lavinia is not. Lavinia is decent. Deputy doesn't seem that great. Skyclave doesn't seem that great. Let's see, I want the fast mana stuff. All right, I want answers to Teferi, though. Nala is kind of gimmicky. As I said, I kind of like trimming a Lotus in Teferi matchups, so I get to play a Skyclave. I think maybe Meddling Mage could be okay. Just name the combo piece I don't have. It's kind of underwhelming. Let's see, I don't want defense grid, I don't want any of the ley lines. So I get one of these four cards. Deputy of Detention. I guess it's an answer to Teferi in some ways. And Omnath too. Alright, let's do that. Alright, Explore into Omnath is kind of nice. Of Lavinia. Mana's awkward. I'll keep though. Alright, and Sand Lotus. So I might want to just sand back Lavinia up just before they It's not even that great because it countered, it still goes to the yard. Let's see. Should I get Hallow's Fountain now or should I play Explore? I think I just play Explore first. See what I hit. Yikes. All that useless green mana. Jeez. I'm not sure I should play it, honestly. Oh, this is gonna be brutal. How awkward. I mean, that's what happens, right? I'm playing Basic Forest, Free Turn Timber, Tube with Seju. It's bound to happen. So maybe second Seju should go. Maybe two turn timber is enough. War Gate, so to get back up. Lotus. All right, I'm gonna tutor now for headquarters because I don't want to draw a land that comes into play tapped and it's blue and white and I drew another freaking turn. I can literally not cast a spell. Are you kidding me? This is unreal. Oh, no. Thought my opening hand was fine. I got a little unlucky on the draw steps. Do like kind of useless grazer. Yeah. All right, this game looks pretty over. Knowing the deck, I can't imagine they just don't have it. Tameshi, okay. I do have to play it out till they at least cast Colossus. That'll instantly scoop to Colossus, though. There's just no way. I definitely have it now if they're like. If they're going off, it means they have it, right? Alright. Or else they wouldn't just keep going crazy after the draw trigger. I mean, Meddling Mage against Lotus Bloom's kind of nice too. I'm gonna stick to my gun suit trimming. I'm gonna just cut a grazer. Stick to my guns. I've only free Lotus Bloom. I think it's correct. You have free blooms, four War Gate to get it, and an engineer that you can even tutor for, so that's a lot of ways to get Lotus Bloom. Mulligan. Sand's fine. Sand's good. That was everything I need. There a reason not to just get all my. Can get headquarter. If I draw engineer, I can just get stomping ground. Late, but could still be good. Oh, I didn't realize they had one. Land is very nice. Do I need Hallowed Fountain for some reason? I don't think so. Same thing as last time, I think it's better to not play Tameshi. So you don't get to draw Teferi. I'd have Teferi again or just Wargate. Looks like Wargate actually. Alright, do they have any hates? I'm not sure what they would have. They could have Endurance. All right, looks like we win. Let's see if they return the curtsy this time or did they make me play it out to the max? Wait, do I actually have enough mana to, Did I mess up? I might have messed up. How much mana do I have? 5, 7, 9? I think I have exactly enough, actually. Yeah. Could have call. That was close, though. That was kind of loose by me. That was real loose. I guess I could get unlucky again, actually. Wait, I don't have mana left. Yeah, I punted. I totally punted. Wow, I got distracted. Oh well, I don't mind. I'm 2-2 anyways, and it's good that you see actually the mistakes you can make. That was a huge mistake. I was supposed to just play the first one. It's typically the spot where you should just maximize your draws. I think I even already had a Wargate backup or something. That was just totally atrocious. I would have had more mana, more cards in hand. For some reason, this version has been... I guess it's because you don't have Renin 6, so you have less lands when you go off, and you have these turn timber. It's not a big difference, but it's 23 plus 3 turn timber. It has felt a little closer, even though, I mean, that was 100% on me. It's not really a turn timber's fault. All right, just show me the money. Just show me a call. Cast a Colossus. So yeah, make sure you let your Colossus die to get that extra trigger if you're like short on resources. Alright. I mean, same thing. If they're going to the lengths of bouncing all their lands, surely they just have Colossus in hand. I could probably save a few seconds here, a few minutes. It kind of feels bad because like I've been saying, oh, they should scoop this, dad, you never fizzle, and then they actually like fizzled, but it was just, I mean, I guess if. Oh, first time GGs. I kind of a feel bad, but better now than playing for high stakes or relatively high stakes. Oh, I mean, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not a I'm kind of annoyed, but it's my fault. Where is it? So, what did I think about the changes? The ley line didn't really come up. Defense grid, I think it's kind of sweet. The fact that you can bring him back with Tamishii is actually pretty cool. The ley lines, I would have to think about it some more, see if it makes sense if I like them. I definitely did like some numbers of Turn Timber. It kind of won me that one game, even though the mana issues also cost me at least a game. So I think maybe freeze one too many. I think the mana is a tiny bit off. Let's see. I think the mana is a tiny bit off. I think maybe making a room for at least a Ren or two could be good. Skyclave, I'm still not sure. In my experience, if you have to like get Skyclave to get rid of their hate card and stuff, it's kind of tough. But maybe it's worth it, so yeah. All in all, I'm actually not sure I love the changes. Like the two finale, that was that one game, I don't remember which game, but I was just stuck with two finale. If one of them had been just a cycling card, things might have gone better. So I like some numbers of Turn Timber. I definitely don't think I like two finales. I think one is more than enough. I like playing some bubbles and stuff. Yeah. I don't think I like all the Baseju and all the Odawara, especially the second Baseju. Just way too much green when you're playing Omnath and Teferi and stuff. That was kind of rough. So, yeah. That's my impressions of the list. As usual, if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a great, great week. And I'll see you all next time. Take care.